No worries. It's not a cooking show. But there's going to be some cooking involved. I'm probably not the best chef in real life, but today I'm going to be cooking with the four chosen ingredients for the Excel Hash Challenge. It's a challenge organized by Oz from Excel on Fire. Now, the participants are my MVP online colleagues. Each one of us needs to make a video that includes four ingredients which were chosen by you: form controls, frequency formula, max function, 3D model. Now, as you can see, not the easiest ingredients to work with. Now, the result can be eatable or not, so basically useful or useless, as long as it includes these four ingredients. We can also use the help of other ingredients to create the final dish. 3D model is an interesting new addition to Office 365, and it's going to be the first time I'm using it. I think it's a good addition for PowerPoint, and I'm going to show you something interesting at the end, so make sure you don't miss that. But before you watch my cooking, what would you cook with these ingredients? Let me know in the comments below. So I'm going to show you my version. Let's just hope it's better than my actual cooking. Let me give you some context. Assume I work in the HR department. I just received this data from my boss. There's information on department, employee name, and the date they started to work at the company. Now, my boss calls me up and tells me this is some information on job tenure, and I want to present it at some employee orientation. It should be somewhat engaging, somewhat entertaining, so that the new employees aren't going to nod off right away. He also wants to have it clustered. So let's say group one shows how many employees are less than a year with the company, then how many are there 1 to 5 years, 5 to 15 years, and more than 15 years. And all of that for each relevant department. I have a suspicion it's not just for the presentation, but he also wants to know how the department leaders are doing in terms of keeping employees. Anyhow, my challenge is to present this in a clear and engaging manner, so I'm going to use images for the clusters. Chicks for newbies, rabbits for the second group, kind of like the job hoppers, pigs for the third group, and for the last one, I'm going to use turtles because they have the longest lifespan. So now I need to figure out how to put this information into these year clusters and also how to analyze this by department and visualize this in a very tasty way. First thing I'm going to do is to get the amount of time that has passed since this date. And for this, I'm going to use my first ingredient. It's a secret ingredient called the dated if function. It's secret because if you type it in here, it doesn't show up on the list. But it's a super handy formula for calculating age, or in this case, the amount of time the person has been with the company. I'm calculating the amount of months that have passed between this day here, between today's date, and I'm dividing it by 12. So this way I can tell who has been there less than a year as well. Let's add the second ingredient now, which is a main ingredient. Form controls. Let's fill it up and connect the result to here. Now, to actually see what the user selected, I'm going to use another side ingredient. It's the index function. I basically look through this list and move down four rows and get what the person selected in here. Now let's bring in the second main ingredient, the frequency function. Frequency function is an array formula. It's quite simple to use. All you need is to give it something that's called the bins category. Those are basically the clusters that my boss was talking about. These are my clusters. I'm going to explain why I have zero here. One is 0 to 1 years, and down here is greater than 15 years. Here you can see how I use the frequency function, but it's frequency with a twist. And the twist is, I'm not looking at the entire data set here, I'm looking at it by criteria. My criteria is sales. My criteria could also be finance. That's going to change things up. Now, the reason I added zero here is because using frequency in this way allows me to kick out the departments that are not valid. So in this case, any department that's not finance is going to get zero, and this way I can kick them out. The six means I have six people working in the finance department for less than a year. And the one means I have one person there that's been working there for greater than 15 years. Let's bring in the third main ingredient, the 3D model. Now I set up the clusters right here just so I know what type of icon I should use for them. 0 to 1 years is a chick. For this, I'm going to use the 3D model. Insert, illustrations, 3D models. From here, I'm just going to do a quick search for chicken. That looks like a nice cute chick. Insert it right here. Now check this out. I can turn this around the way I want. I also have some options right here under format. I can pan and zoom, change the height, use one of these here. So I'm just going to format it the way I like, make it smaller and put it here. I'm going to do the same thing for the turtle. Grab an image from the 3D model, size it correctly and put it here. One thing to watch out for is that these 3D models can really explode your file. So keep an eye on the file size. To make sure my file size doesn't explode, for the rabbit and the pig, I'm actually going to insert an icon from here. Now we have the three ingredients in place. We haven't mixed them up to create a dish. We're still missing one main ingredient, but let's start with our dish. Let's start putting it in the oven and then add in our last main ingredient. Based on this data set, I'm going to create a chart. And I'm going to prepare the data for my chart by just typing out the categories so it's easy to understand what they are. This is not so easy to read. I'm going to add the number of employees right here. You can see this is just referencing this cell. Now let's insert the chart. Reverse these categories. Let's just make sure this is dynamic until now. I'm going to send this to the back. It's starting to come together. It doesn't include my images yet, so let's bring them in. I want to position each image at the end of the chart here, so I'm going to use a scatter plot for the series of my images. For that, I need numbers. I'm just going to use these for now. And then I'm going to bring in and replace this with our final ingredient. And you're going to see why that last ingredient is going to give it a perfect touch. Let's add these in as a scatter plot. Select data, add series name, icons, series values. Now, the Y is going to be a secondary axis that's going to pop up here. Why? Because these are not numbers. I need my Y to translate this category to a 1, 2, 3, and to a 4. So actually what I'm going to do, I'm just going to type them in. 1, 2, 3, 4. My categories are fixed. They're not going to change. So I can actually type them in here. But you can also type them in Excel cells. And those curly brackets that we saw before come automatically. Now, I need the X values as well, but I can't add them in because it's not a scatter plot yet. So let's go and do that. See this? It's automatically putting it on the secondary axis. Now I get my numbers here, but I want these to be restricted to 0.5, and I think 4.5 is good. And the reason it's 0.5 and 4.5 is because I want this one to be a 1 and the last one to be a 4. Right now it's the other way around, so let's switch them values in reverse order. Positioning looks kind of good. This one is supposed to be on the end here. This one is supposed to be here. Why is it not there? Because it's missing the X values. I haven't given them yet, so let's select them right here. Positioning is perfect. Now let's add in our images. All we need to do, copy, click, click, two times click. Otherwise, you're gonna paste this for all of the series here. Paste. Let's repeat for the other ones. Now this is starting to look interesting, but it's not going to look as good without our last main ingredient, max function. What is that max function going to do to make this much better? Is that right now, this just looks like a little cute drawing somewhere, but I don't want it to be a little cute drawing. I just want the symbol that has the highest number. I want the other symbols to disappear. So in this case, I just want to show the pig. If I switch to sales, I just want to show the turtle. I don't want these there. Let's bring in the max function. All I'm doing here is checking to see, is this number the max in here? And if it is, it's going to put that number. Otherwise, it's going to write an error. And the reason I write an error is that's the way I'm going to hide the other series. Excel can't put these type of errors. It breaks your series. Now, one tweak I'm going to make to this is instead of showing the exact same number, I'm going to multiply this by a small percentage. That just moves it a little bit out of the way. Okay, so all the ingredients have been added to create this dish, but it doesn't look very tasty and appealing right now. So let's just update the formatting of this to create a tasty dish out of it. And that's the decorated version of our dish. We can quickly see the finance department has a lot of new employees there. Now, I'm sure my boss is going to follow up on this, but I think it has something to do with the department leader. Now, let's switch to the sales department. There we have a lot of turtles. So we have a lot of senior people, and that's a good thing because they know our product best. Let's just quickly take a look at marketing. We have 4 people who have been there within 1 to 5 years, and procurement, we have 5 people, 5 to 15 years. So I think my boss is going to be happy with this analysis. That was my solution. We used the 4 ingredients to get our wonderful bar chart. And in addition, we used a few Excel tricks like the secret date if function, an A function to get our images to work on the chart, scatter plot inside the bar chart, and we incorporated our 3D images. Now, here comes a quick bonus tip I talked about at the beginning. It's an example of using 3D models in PowerPoint. Let's say I was making a presentation to show the number of employees by employment time in the finance department. I could do this. You can get this funny, interesting, different animation effect. Now, here's where you come in. Watch all 6 videos in the Excel Hash playlist. You're going to find the link below and also in the cards. Then vote for your favorite. Link for voting is also in the description of the video. And here's how it looks. You're going to see the name of the YouTube channel and the name of the recipe. 5-star means great video. 1-star, not so great. I hope you found something new here. Please cast your vote. See you in the next video. Oh, and if you're serious about learning Excel, subscribe to the YouTube channels of the other creators in the Excel Hash playlist.